Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. This video will cover Langerhans cell histiocytosis. The references for this video are these. So we will look for the solution of this clinical scenario in which an 18 months old girl presents to the pediatric clinic with a recurring otitis media and a widespread skin rash. The physical examination shows cutaneous lesion resembling a seborrheic eruption over her trunk and the scalp. In addition to otitis media of her left ear, hepatosplenomegaly and cervical lymphadenopathy are also present. The serum studies shows marked edema and thrombosis. Langerhans cell histiocytosis, which was previously known as histiocytosis X, can be considered an unusual myeloid neoplasm. It is actually clonal proliferation of a special type of immature dendritic cells that are the Langerhans cells. This term is a generic term for three entities characterized by proliferation of Langerhans cell in various tissues. First among these is eosinophilic granuloma, which is a localized form. Another is Hand-Schuller-Christian disease, which is a disseminated variant of this disease. Third one is lateral Syve disease, which is fulminant and often fatal and generalized disease. The pathogenesis of the Langerhans cell histiocytosis was always considered controversial, but it is now considered that most of them are associated with driver mutations. The most common mutation is in the BRAF, which is present in about 55 to 60% of the cases, and it is an activating valine to glutamate substitution at residue 600. Less common mutations are in TP53, RAS and receptor tyrosine kinase MET mutation. The factors which is responsible for the collection of these histiocytes into certain tissue is due to expression of receptor CCR6 and CCR7 by the neoplastic Langerhans cell. Normally, the Langerhans cell only expresses CCR6, but these neoplastic cell they express CCR6 and CCR7 both. With the expression of both these receptors, the histiocytes, they travel toward the specific tissue from which there is expression of the chemokine. As the chemokine for the CCR6 is CCL20, and it is expressed in skin and bone, and the receptor ligand for the CCR7 is CCL19 and 21, which is from the lymphoid organ. So these chemokine liberation will result in homing or collection of these histiocytes. The morphological picture for all three variants of Langerhans cell histiocytosis is identical. There is collection of large histiocytes with the pale eosinophilic cytoplasm and convoluted or grooved nuclei. Immunohistochemistry, they are positive for CD1A, Langerhans, and S100 proteins. On electron microscopy, there is racket-shaped tubular structure that is termed as Birbeck granule. There is collection of the eosinophils. Sometimes this collection is very large in number and form eosinophilic abscess. Multinucleated osteoclastic giant cells are also observed, and chronic inflammatory cells and neutrophil. These lesions can appear anywhere in the body, including bone, skin, brain, lungs, lymph node, liver, and spleen. And radiology is identical. There is it involves metaphysis or diaphysis of the long bone or flat bone, such as the skull, there is a punched out lytic defect with which there is no reactive surrounding bone formation. Such lesions may precipitate fracture and there is formation of periosteal callus. This photomicrograph is showing that there is collection of the large osteocytes, and these osteocytes are containing eosinophilic cytoplasm and folded, convoluted or grouped nuclei. There is some presence of eosinophils also. These cells are positive for the Langerhans, HLA-DR, S100 and CD1A on immunohistochemistry. This photomicrograph is showing that there is cytoplasmic and nuclear positivity for S100 protein. Electron microscopy of the histocyte shows rod-like structures with dilated end, imparting a picture of a racket. These are termed as Purbeck granules. The X-ray of the skull shows a large lytic lesion. There is no surrounding new bone formation. The eosinophilic granuloma can be solitary or multiple, and it accounts for more than 70% of the cases of Langerhans cell histiocytosis. It affects people in first two decades of the life, and morphologically one or two bony lytic lesions are present, affecting the axial or appendicular skeleton. Calvarial ribs and femur are most commonly affected sites. The lesion may be present in skin, lung and stomach also, and it present with mild pain. However, some cases can remain asymptomatic. The involvement of the vertebrae is associated with the collapse of the vertebrae and pathological fracture. However, the vertebrae tends to regenerate after some time, and eventually the recovery is the role in this eosinophilic granuloma. Hand-Schuller-Christian disease is a multifocal disease. It accounts for 20% of all cases of Langerhans cell histiocytosis. Affects younger age group, and the age group involved is 2 to 5 years of age. It is more widespread lesion than in eosinophilic granuloma. The site involved usually is the calvaria, rib, and pelvis and scapulae. And the lesion is same, the radiolucent lytic lesion in the bone. When it infiltrate into the bone, there is loss of teeth, and radiologically the teeth give appearance of a floating teeth. When it infiltrates the retroorbital space, it results manifest itself as exophthalmos. When there is infiltration of the hypothalamic pituitary stalk, it results in diabetes insipidus. 20% of the cases are associated with lymphadenopathy and lung infiltrate also. The skin lesion is characteristic, that is crusty, red, VP lesion at the hairline and on the extensor surface of the extremities. The lesion may be present on the abdomen and occasionally sole of the feet. When the external auditory canal and mastoid ear cells are affected, it results in deafness. Liver and spleen are affected in 33% of the cases. Bone is involved in 40% of the cases, and in about half of these cases, skull is the most common site. The classical triad of Hand-Schuller-Christian disease is radiolucent lesion of the skull, diabetes insipidus and exophthalmos, and it is present in 1/3 of the patient. The third variant, that is Leiter Seib disease, is an aggressive, potentially fatal variant of this disease, and luckily it comprises only 10% of the cases of Langerhans cell histiocytosis. The age group is children less than 2 years of age who fail to thrive and become cachectic, and some of the cases are also reported in adults. There is multiple organ involvement, and with the massive splenomegaly, hepatic enlargement, lymphadenopathy, and subsequent consequent anemia, leukopenia, and thrombocytopenia. Skin lesions are widely scattered with seborrheic lesions and sometimes hemorrhagic lesions. Bone lesions are not prominent initially, but due to progressive marrow replacement and pulmonary infiltration, this causes death. In some instances, the proliferating cells are quite anaplastic, and these cases are termed as Langerhans cell sarcoma. The untreated later Syphe disease is rapidly fatal, and if treated, prognosis is 50% for 5 years. The pulmonary Langerhans cell histiocytosis is it presents as isolated lesion or diffuse cystic lung disease. It's a special category of the disease which is usually seen in adult smoker, and it regresses upon cessation of the smoking. It is considered that it is reactive proliferation of the Langerhans cell, but 40% of the cases are associated with the BRAF mutations, so it is the etiology is still questionable. So the histology is same, almost same. There is a scattered nodular infiltrate with a stellate border or extending into the surrounding interstitium. And the site is subpleura or bronchioles. With the progression of the disease, there is cavitation of the lesion and subsequent fibrosis of the lung, which give the characteristic honeycomb appearance. The adjacent parenchyma also shows the accumulation of intraalveolar macrophages. These are due to the respiratory bronchiolitis, which is caused by the smoking. So on the left side of the photomicrograph, you can see that these lesion of the pulmonary Langerhans cell histiocytosis are a stellate shape, and they are sending extension into the surrounding tissue. On the right side, the histology is evident, and it's similar to that we have discussed earlier. The pulmonary Langerhans cell histiocytosis affect people in third and fourth decades of their life. 25% of the cases are asymptomatic, while other present with non-productive cough, dyspnea on exertion, and spontaneous pneumothorax. Cessation of the smoking has got a beneficial role if it is in the early stages of the disease. The X-ray chest shows diffuse bilateral reticulonodular lesions in the upper lobe that frequently undergo cavitation. Prognosis is good, and in some cases can lead to the chronic pulmonary dysfunction, and mortality is due to progressive pulmonary fibrosis, if any, and it is less common. The clinical feature for the Langerhans cell histiocytosis, the eosinophilic granuloma, is a self-limited disease. There is a bony lesion which can be curated and packed with bone chips, and sometimes only biopsy stimulates the repair of the lytic lesion. As we have discussed earlier, collapsed vertebrae may actually reconstitute itself as the time advances. Hand-Schuller disease can be treated by radiation therapy for some bones, and especially the retroorbital lesion. Then diabetes insipidus is irreversible usually, and the other drugs which are used for Hand-Schuller Christian disease are corticosteroids, cyclophosphamide, and various tumor residual agents. The lateral Syphe disease is it needs aggressive chemotherapy. Now you should be able to answer the scenario we discussed in the start of this video. So this is a quiz related to this video. 2 years old boy present with a rash on physical examination. He has a crusty red skin lesion at the hairline and also on the extensor surface of his extremities and abdomen. Exophthalmos is also noted. X-ray film of the head show multiple radiolucent lesion in the skull. biopsy of this lesion is showing multiple plum cell with pale cytoplasm, foamy cytoplasm, pale eosinophilic and foamy cytoplasm, and convoluted nuclei, and there are a lot of eosinophils also. So what is your likely diagnosis? Good, this is the Hand-Schuller-Christian disease. This slide is made for the recall of what we have learned in this video. Just recall in your mind what are the microscopic features, what is the provisional diagnosis, what three entities encompass the term Langerhans cell histiocytosis, what are the clinico-pathological features of eosinophilic granuloma and its related disorders.